Welcome, or welcome back, to 4F Beauty. When will I be YouTube famous? Who knows? What I do know is I got hot, so I put my hair up in a pony and just left the sides and fringe down, which normally when I do this, it confuses people and they compliment me on my new haircut, so awesome. Right, today's film, I've been looking back, I've been sort of like indulging and going through and looking at other people's tag videos from ages ago, from before I had a YouTube channel, to see if there's any that I liked the look of. And I've been looking at some of Nona's from My So-Called Life 1977. I will link her channel down below. And she'd done quite a few from like before I had a channel. So, I am going to answer some of the tag questions that I found on her channel. And this first one is the 20 questions tag. Now, she didn't mention who started the tag, and I can't see it listed anywhere as to who started it. So if you know who started this tag, please let me know and I'll pin it in a comment. But here we go. 20 questions tag. Question number one, thing you can't leave the house without? My stick, because I ain't going to get very far without it. In terms of kind of makeup, then SPF, because my skin goes from white to lobster and back to white again. So yeah, my stick and a good sun cream, and those are the two things I cannot leave without. Two, favourite brand of makeup. I suppose the brand that I've got the most things from would be Revolution, and they are certainly a very, very good brand. So in terms of drugstore or high street or cheaper, more economical brands, I'd say Revolution. In terms of high-end brands, I know this is going to be controversial, but Jeffree Star. I started off with his liquid lipsticks, funny enough, wearing one today. And then fell in love with his eyeshadows, and the formula of those have just continued getting better over the years. So those are my two. Favourite flower? Freesias, because they're tiny, but they're beautiful and they have the most magnificent scent. Freesias and white carnations, I think, are my favourites. That would be my ideal bunch of flowers. White carnations with freesias. Yeah. Four, favourite clothing store. Now, I don't really go out shopping for clothes anymore because physically it's too tiring. I end up exhausted, so I do most of mine as online shopping, and it's probably either Fashion World or Yours Clothing, and Yours Clothing do actually have high street locations as well. It used to be Evans, but they've got a bit expensive compared to Yours and to Fashion World, and they're also, when I look at, I used to get a lot of like t-shirts and stuff from them because they had like really funky ones with like Betty Boop on it and sarcastic slogans and stuff, and they feel a bit old. Now that sounds daft, but they just do. Favourite perfume? Again, I have two. Chanel No. 5, absolute classic, adore that. And believe it or not, cheaper option for you. Britney Spears, Fantasy, the original one, in the hot pink bottle with the clear crystals. Love that, really, really nice. Six, heels or flats? Used to be heels all the time. I've got osteoarthritis in my spine, I cannot wear heels anymore, so it's gotta be flats, unfortunately. Seven, did you make good grades? Yeah, I did. I was never a straight A student, but you know, in terms of my school that I went to, I was in the top sort of 3% in terms of GCSE grades that we got that year. Yeah, I made pretty good grades. Eight favourite colours: purple, green, blue, red. Four of the most difficult colours to create in terms of makeup. Brilliant. Do you drink energy drinks? Yes. Yes, I do. Yes. Do you drink juice? Yes, but less often because the high fibre that you get in fresh juice can really play havoc with my IBS, but my favourite juice is pineapple. Do you like swimming? Yes, I do. It's a, you know, it's a non-weight bearing exercise. It's about the only thing really that I've been able to do for a long time without causing too much pain, but I'm now finding even that difficult because the arthritis, although the water takes a lot of your weight off of your joints, the physical, trying to do the crawl, I just can't do the crawl anymore. Butterfly is difficult. I kind of have to sort of doggy paddle at the front, which is a bit, doesn't really get you very far, to be quite honest. Do you eat fries with a fork? If they're on a plate, yes. If they're in a carton from the drive-thru, no. Favourite moisturiser? At the moment, it's this one. This is the L'Oreal Age Perfect Cell Renewal Rosy Tone Cream. Not very easy to get in the UK. I found a site that looked like it was a UK site and ordered it, and turned out it was overseas and I got clobbered with customs and stuff on arrival, so that's annoying. But yeah, at the moment, that one. Do you want to get married? No, because I already am married, thank you, and I absolutely love him. And yesterday was actually our 5-year wedding anniversary, so... 15. Do you get mad easily? I'm a Taurian. I'm extremely patient. I'm like a firework, like the blue touch paper, and you've got quite a while before it gets to the explosion. Unless you're hurting my family or my godkids, in which case I'm gonna tear you a new one. And I can be a vicious bitch. I really can. I can be a really nasty bitch if you hurt my family or my friends or somebody that I care about. So just don't hurt people that I care about and we'll be absolutely fine. Are you into ghost hunting? No, because physically I just can't anymore, but I love watching them. I think probably my favourite is Ghost Adventures with Zach and Aaron and all that lot. I really enjoy that show. Do you have any phobias? Yes. Bees and wasps, but only because I'm allergic to them. So that, phobia is kind of an irrational fear, but because I'm allergic to them, that makes it a rational fear. So I guess that's not a phobia. I have issues with butterflies and moths. For a long time, even if someone was wearing a t-shirt with a butterfly on it, I couldn't go anywhere near them. It freaked me out. I'm getting better with butterflies. I actually had a red admiral land on the windscreen of my car. And I was like, oh my God, I haven't seen one of those for years. And suddenly realised I was fascinated by the butterfly and not freaking out about it. Whether that's because there was a pane of glass between me and it, I'm not sure. But I am getting better now. I can actually, if someone's wearing a butterfly top, I don't automatically recoil anymore. And I can use the Snapchat filter with butterflies, but moths... and heights. I'm not good with heights. If I stand at the edge of something that's really high, I get this urge to fling myself off. Do you bite your nails? No. I never have bitten my nails, ever. And now I have acrylic to protect my natural nails. No, I don't. 19, have you ever had a near-death experience? Yeah, actually. I got pneumonia a couple of days before my 43rd birthday, so 2 years ago. I came very close. I didn't tell my husband this, but at the time I didn't think I was going to pull through. I thought that was it. The doctor took one look and wanted to admit me to hospital, and my reaction was, I'm not going into hospital. Do you know how many people die in those places? And we stayed at my mother-in-law's for a couple of weeks while I sort of recuperated and tried to fight it, because our bedroom there has an ensuite, which the house I'm in now, the bathroom is downstairs and the bedroom is upstairs, and I was barely able to get myself out of bed and drag myself 10 steps to the bathroom at the ensuite and back again. And when I arrived, my brother-in-law described me as looking rather zombie-ish when I first arrived. My skin was grey, my lips were blue, my oxygen sats were so low. I was convinced I wasn't that sick because my oxygen sats were so low that I was kind of not really thinking straight at all. But yeah, I very nearly didn't get through that one. But it obviously wasn't my day to go, because I'm still here. And finally, number 20, do you drink coffee? Yes, I like coffee. I've got a lot of jars of the Beanies coffee, which is, if you don't add any sugar or milk to it, it's 2 calories per cup. They've got amazing flavours like pumpkin spice and chocolate orange and nutmeg and chocolate mint and caramel and vanilla. It's nice. And I also very often do myself an iced coffee in the fridge. I do myself a cold brew. So yeah, that was the 20 questions. That's a little bit more about me for you to know. I hope you found that a little bit interesting, maybe. If you haven't done this tag and you want to, then I'd love to hear you do it. I am going to tag a few people. Nikki Raven, my YouTube wifey, I tag you. Jessica from Starshollywood, Jessica, I tag you. And Linda Wallinder, I tag you. To do these questions. Right, please double check you are still subscribed, because YouTube do keep unsubscribing people. And now all that remains for me to say, as ever, is you'll stay fabulous, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.